Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Vital Induction. Today I am going to describe about ultrasound guided obturator nerve block. So let's get started. Obturator nerve block, per se I find it very difficult to block it by using landmark techniques. But on the other hand, if we use ultrasound, the procedure becomes very easy. To understand how to use ultrasound to block obturator nerve, let's quickly refresh the anatomy. Obturator nerve starts as anterior primary rami of L2, L3 and L4 nerves. After that, it descends along with the medial border of psoas muscles and it comes out of the pelvic cavity through obturator foramen, after which it divides into anterior and posterior branches. So best place to block obturator nerve using ultrasound is when it divides into anterior and posterior branches. Anterior branch, it can be found using ultrasound between adductor longus and adductor brevis muscle. And on the other hand, the posterior branch lies between adductor brevis and adductor magnus muscle. In an in-plane technique, you can see the needle entering from the lateral aspect of the probe. After crossing the adductor longus muscle, the needle lies between both the muscle belly. Here the drug is injected. Now, after the drug is injected, we move ahead to block the posterior branch of obturator nerve. Here again, 4 to 5 ml of drug is injected. So the duration of analgesia will depend on the type of local anesthetic used. So what are the uses of obturator nerve block? The uses are, number one, to provide analgesia for hip and knee surgery. Number two, to relieve adductor muscle spasms. Number three, to avoid obturator jerk during TURBT surgery. So this was all about ultrasound guided obturator nerve block. See you in my next video. Till then, bye.